Hey folks, back with a quick video about the Xserve. Now, what I'm about to show you applies to every Xserve, whether it's a G4, G5, or Intel, but there are slight differences, which I will cover. The point of this video is to tell you how to start up an Xserve from the front panel. You can, if you don't have a mouse or keyboard attached, then you can, using these buttons, you can select which mode you want to start up in using these activity lights. So to do that, you have to hold down the system identifier button before you power on the Mac. Once you have this button held down, fire it up, keep holding this button. So I'm going to show you that right now. I'm going to block the shot while I do it, but hold that down, fire it up. Now you're going to keep this button pushed in until you got a pretty neat Knight Rider effect going on over here, and then you can let the button go. There it is. Let me zoom in on this. All right. Now using the system identifier button, so that one right there, you're gonna select the mode. I'll be covering the G5 first because that's what I have in front of me. Option number one, by the way, this is all from right to left. So option number one is basically start up from the system disk. And that means optical drive. Whatever is in the optical drive, that's what it will boot up from. Option number two, there we go, start up from a network server. So if you're on a network that has a netboot or net restore server available, it'll reach out, find the available images, select the one that's appropriate, and boot up from that. Option three, start up from the internal hard drive. Pretty self-explanatory. In the case of an Xserve cluster node, there's only one hard drive to worry about. In case of a regular Xserve with three, or in the G4's case, four hard drive bays, it'll always try to boot up from the left hard drive bay. So, say you can save yourself some time if your operating system is on the bay all the way on the right. It doesn't have to waste time looking for it if you just squeeze it onto the left bay. On to option number four. This is ignore the current startup disk, find any other startup disk, and boot up from that. In case you're dealing with an operating system issue or a corruption, this is a quick way to bypass that system. Number five, begin target disk mode. Self-explanatory, especially handy in the case of a cluster node Xserve, where you don't have, typically you don't have a graphics card in there, but this can be convenient for any server if you don't have a keyboard or a mouse handy. And let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to number six. Let me think. Number six is a PRAM or NVRAM reset. Reset the system defaults on the hardware. It might get a little noisy now because I'm taking too long, so the server is freaking out. Number seven, if you have something connected to the serial port, it will enter open firmware mode. If you have a mouse and keyboard connected, it'll enter open firmware mode on the display. So you need to have one of those connected as well. And finally, light number eight is enter diagnostic test mode. Once you make a selection, so I'm gonna stick with number three, start up from the hard drive, hold down the system identifier for 2 seconds. All the lights will turn solid, and now it's set. As you can see right there. Now once the operating system load, the fans will quiet down. It'll stop freaking out. There we go. So that's how you boot up your server from the using the front panel. Now let me turn this off, because we don't need it to actually fire up here. Reposition the camera. There we go. Now for the Intel, it is different. Let me think. Yeah, for the Intel is different. So again, from right to left, you have optical drive, number one, netboot server, number two. The first available system on a hard drive is number three. So it doesn't matter what you set, it'll find whatever is available and pick it and boot from it. Let me think. Yeah, that's three. Number four is skip the current startup disk, just like with the G5, and boot from any system that it can find. I have to make sure I get this right. I don't want to mess you up. Yeah, number five, target disk mode. Number six is reset the NVRAM and start up from the first bootable drive module. So that is, doesn't matter which bay it's in, it'll pick it and boot from it if it can find it. Now a little trick with the Intels, light number seven is not used. So if you select that, nothing will happen. The few cases I've accidentally done that, the fans freak out and it just doesn't do anything. And number eight, so from right to left, number eight, the last one, that is similar to the G5, it will start up in diagnostic mode, but only if it finds a netboot server with a diagnostic image on it. Now I looked this up and the wording for the G5, it doesn't mention a netboot server. So the G5 either has a diagnostic image on board that it'll run, or Apple just forgot to mention the netboot server in the documentation. I'm not sure. But for the Intel, it specifically says you need a netboot server, sorry, a netboot server to start up in that diagnostic mode. So keep that in mind. And let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, that's it. And on all the servers, selecting one of the options is the same. Once you made your selection, hold this down until all the lights turn solid up here, and it'll boot up in that mode. So it might come in handy if you don't have a mouse and keyboard handy and you need to do target disk mode real quick. Here's how you do it. If you need to boot up in from a CD-ROM or a DVD installer and you don't have a keyboard handy to hold down the C key, this might come in handy. You know, maybe you're having some hardware issues, you need to do an NVRAM reset, or use that diagnostic mode I just told you about. This might come in handy. So hopefully this will come in handy for you at some point. And if it does, let me know in the comments. See you next time.